Hello everyone, it's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with this week's edition of Protect Your Portfolio. In this weekly presentation, we take a longer-term look at the North American markets using weekly charts. Now we use weekly charts to help filter out all of that market noise from Monday to Friday, so you're left with just one decision point, and that of course is the closing price from 4 p.m. Friday afternoon. Now, I'm doing this presentation before the market opens on Monday morning, and the futures are a little weird this morning. We've got Dow futures up over 200 points. The S&P 500 is doing fine, but the NASDAQ is basically unchanged in the pre-market on Monday morning. So no leadership from the NASDAQ on Monday. Commodities are mixed. Crude oil is lower. Gold is higher on Monday morning. Gold is still trading below $1,700 in the pre-market. Now, if you were with us last week, of course, we start every presentation looking at the VIX or the Fear Index. Last week at this time, the upper trend line was up at 44.56. So we were going to remain long-term bullish on the market as long as the VIX did not close above that level. Move ahead a week and the upper trend line has continued to move lower and we're now at 42.23. So as long as the VIX does not close above that this coming Friday, we will remain long-term bullish on the market. Now, looking short-term level, the VIX moved down below $25 on Friday. The high of the day was $25.09, so we are still attached to the $25 level. That's a big area of support for the VIX. Looking up, we need to close on Monday above $29.12 to give us a new buy signal. That would turn us, of course, short-term bearish on the market. And if that doesn't happen on Monday, that upper trend line is going to continue to move lower daily. There we are hanging on to the $25 level. You can see there's a nice open gap that could be filled before we get down towards 1250. So that could be an area of support on the way down. Looking at a weekly chart of the SPDR ETF, we had a nice move up over nearly 5% on the week. Our next mathematical target to the upside is 328.13. And if we can take that out, then we go back to retest the highs from earlier in the year. Now, the NASDAQ doesn't have to retest any highs because it's broken through the highs from earlier this year, heading towards 250 on the Qs. What worked? Well, anything energy related had a great week, and the banks finally showed up, and they also had a great week. Of course, if you own the Dow Diamonds, the SPDR ETF, or any major ETF that covers the market, you're already heavily weighted in the financial sector. What didn't work? Well, anything VIX related, of course, and the gold sector pulled back. On the GDX, we pulled back into the channel. A close below 30 this coming Friday would give us a new sell signal for the GDX. Moving from the U.S. market to the Canadian market, we had a nice week. The iShares for the TSX 60 moved up nicely. We've taken out resistance, our mathematical target at 23.44. We've also filled the open gap, and so our next mathematical target to the upside is $25. What worked? Well, just like in the U.S., energy stocks were up nicely, haven't filled the open gap yet. Anything real estate related had a good week. Any of the REITs, any of the real estate stocks themselves. We also saw Canadian banks move up sharply, just like they did in the U.S. They've now filled the open gap, so now we have to see if the top of that gap is resistance or if we're able to break through. What didn't work? Well, just like in the U.S., so we saw gold stocks come down. We're looking at the iShares for the gold sector, traded through the lower channel line. We need to close this coming Friday below $18.63. Let's finish off today's presentation with a quick look at commodities and no trend changes to talk about. Crude oil had a great week, up over 11%, hitting the lower channel line. We need to close this coming Friday above 34.59 to give us a buy signal for crude oil. Looking at gasoline, we had a nice week, took out the previous 2 weeks' highs, and now it looks like we're going for the bottom of the next open gap. No joy for natural gas. We're down a little on the week and still trading below the lower channel line. No change in trend for the GLD. The GLD traded back into the channel, so it closed below 155.67. This coming Friday would give us a new sell signal for the GLD. We spent a couple of months trying to break through the 162.50 level, and we were not able to do so. So we've been playing between 137.50 and 162.50 for quite a while now, and looking to see if we can break out of that range in 2020. Looking at palladium, no joy, up slightly on the week. Looking at platinum, we had a small pullback, no change in trend, and no change in trend for silver. Silver put in a bearish reversal week, tried to hit 1719, got as high as 1710 on the SLV. There's the bearish reversal signal. I noticed that the pros never took control since this last rally started. Compare that to the GLD. So a lot more interest from the pros in gold than in silver at this time. Okay, folks, that is all for today's presentation. The next time you'll hear my voice is on Tuesday morning. And at that time, we'll open up the daily charts and take a closer look at the North American markets.